Welcome, friends. Welcome back to Cocktails After Dark. Today we're going to do a cocktail out of this 1946 cocktail book called Trader Vic's Book of Food and Drink. And this is much more than a cocktail book. It really is a book. It's a lifestyle book. It talks all about how to throw your party, what to serve at your party, a bunch of recipes to serve at your party, drinks for your party, what to do with unruly party guests, how to get rid of them, how to make up your guest list in the first place. It really is a total lifestyle of tiki. And I'm not a huge fan of tiki. There's some things about it that bother me a little bit, but I do like the cocktails. So today we're going to do something called the Hua Pala. I think that's how you pronounce it. It is a Trader Vic original, and it's denoted in the book as a Trader Vic original. So we're going to start out with a dash of grenadine, and I'm going to make this cocktail two ways, like we always do. Dash of grenadine, and this is our homemade grenadine, and we'll see if I can actually get a dash. How about a bar spoon of grenadine? There we go. Next in is some lemon juice, and yes, it is freshly squozen. So, here we go. Same amount in each mixing glass. Next up is gin. So, I'm going to use this Dillon's gin in this cocktail. And then I'm actually going to clean out the jigger with some rum. And I'm going to use this Diplomático 8-Year rum. It's not the one specified in the actual recipe, but so far this has proven to be a really nice rum for mixing. And in this cocktail, I'm going to use Bombay Sapphire gin just to compare the flavors. Okay, I'm going to ice, shake, and pour the Dillon's first, and then come back and do the Sapphire second. Okay, pour out the first one. And double strain, but you don't have to. And we'll ice the second. Hey, Jules.
Hi, Glenn. Hi, friends.
So, the Hua Pala.
The Hua Pala?
It is from Trader Vic's Book of Food and Drink. And Trader Vic is known as being Mr. Tiki.
Okay.
But this is a decidedly untiki cocktail. There's a whole section in this book that are untiki cocktails. Like there's none of that, all that stuff that you see in a tiki cocktail.
I don't see any extra bits shoved in it.
No, it is
no fruit. No.
This is from a section in his book where at most there's a cocktail onion.
Well, you know, if it's about holding a party. Mm-hmm. You've got to have drinks for everyone.
Yes. So. Something that's easy to make, something that's really quick to bring out to the party, which is probably why his most famous recipe is not in here, which is the Mai Tai.
Oh, there you go.
Not in this book. So let's give it a go. That is the Dillon's gin, and this one is the Sapphire.
Okay. It's got a bit of a bite to it. It's okay.
Yeah.
It's not a grand...
Doesn't blow me away.
It's not a grand drink for me. I think the it's all lemon.
The lemon. And the lemon is the least amount of anything. It's not balanced to me.
Yeah.
Like it doesn't... So the one with the Bombay Sapphire, I find completely flat in terms of flavor profile. Like there's nothing that says, I've got something in my mouth that I would really want to have in my mouth. It's not there. This one has a little bit of something that is a little bit of it's sharp.
Yeah, but it's not.
But it's still not.
Not a drink for me. But might be a drink for you. Who am I to say?
Well, and that's it. Different gins again different rums again, and the cocktail is completely different. It just says to use a light rum, which isn't a white rum. It's a light rum, so it has been aged. So it's been on age for a while. It says to use Bacardi. I'm not a huge fan of Bacardi rums to begin with. Don't let the grenadine pull the wool over your eyes. I don't know why the grenadine was going to pull the wool over my eyes, but it doesn't seem to add anything either.
I think that's kind of a funny statement for a handful of reasons. One, it's a book full of tiki drinks.
Yeah.
So I'm not really sure where the judgment's coming in. Like, I don't know how we can judge one drink for having grenadine when so many of the other drinks in this book have so many other additional
components,
flavors
yeah.
that add sweetness and fruit. And yeah. So
they're all fruity drinks. I don't know what the problem is. Okay, so not a winner. But if you might like it. And that's the thing about cocktails. Just because we don't find it that great doesn't mean that someone else isn't going to absolutely love it. So let us know down below in the comments what you think. There was another gin and rum drink that we did a little while ago.
It was very similar.
The Atlantic.
That we both happened to like.
Really liked that one.
So, and it was just a subtle difference, right?
I think
anyway.
Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.